In this screencast, we're going to look at some ways to level up your presentation skills with IntelliJ IDEA. Our first tip is to use the Presentation Assistant plugin. The Presentation Assistant plugin will show which shortcuts are being used. To install the plugin, open Preferences using Command and Comma on Mac or Control Alt and S on Windows and Linux. Go to Plugins and search for Presentation Assistant. Click Install. And when it's done, click Apply and OK. To configure the Presentation Assistant, go back to Preferences and go to Appearance and Behavior, Presentation Assistant. Here we can configure the font size, duration, alignment, and which key maps to show. We're using macOS with Windows as the alternative key map. When presenting, you can use Presentation Mode. You can switch to Presentation Mode by clicking View, Appearance, Enter Presentation Mode. The IDE switches to full screen and everything is hidden except for the main editor window. The font size is increased so it's easier to read from a distance. Exit Presentation Mode by clicking View, Appearance, Exit Presentation Mode. If needed, the font size in Presentation Mode can be configured in Preferences, Appearance and Behavior, Appearance. Scroll down to Presentation Mode, Font Size, and set the font size you want. Click Apply and OK. We can also open Presentation Mode using shortcuts. Open the Quick Switch Scheme using Control apostrophe on Mac or Control and apostrophe on Windows and Linux. Use the arrows to select View Mode and then select Enter Presentation Mode. We see that the font size is bigger this time because we configured it. We can use Quick Switch Scheme again to exit Presentation Mode. To enable Mouse Zoom, you need to turn it on explicitly. Go to Preferences, Editor, General, and select Change Font Size with Command and Mouse Wheel when you're on Mac, or Change Font Size with Control and Mouse on Windows and Linux. Click Apply and OK. Now we can use Command and Mouse Wheel on Mac or Control and Mouse on Windows and Linux to zoom in or out. And we can reset to the original size. To configure font and font size, go to Preferences, Editor, Font. We can select the font we want to use and set the font size. When presenting in person, make sure that the font can be read from a distance. If possible, check out the room where you'll be speaking. Do your setup before your talk, and walk to the back of the room to check if your code is readable. By default, IntelliJ IDEA uses the Darkula theme. To change it, go to Preferences, Appearance and Behavior, Appearance. Select the UI theme from the theme list. IntelliJ Lite is a traditional light theme for IntelliJ-based IDEs. macOS Lite or Windows 10 Lite is an OS-specific light theme available as a bundled plugin. Darkula is the default dark theme that we're using here. High Contrast is a theme designed for users with color vision deficiency. We recommend closing all unused windows so we can focus on the code we're looking at. Use Command-Shift-F12 on Mac or Control-Shift-F12 on Windows and Linux to hide all tool windows. We can always reopen them using shortcuts. Here are the shortcuts to some of the most used windows. To open or close the project window, use Command and 1 on Mac or Alt and 1 on Windows and Linux. To open or close the commit window, use Command and 0 on Mac or Alt and 0 on Windows and Linux. To open or close the terminal window, use Alt F12. To open or close the Git tool window, use Command and 9 on Mac or Alt and 9 on Windows and Linux. To open and close the Run tool window, use Command and 4 on Mac or Alt and 4 on Windows and Linux. You can also use keyboard shortcuts to stretch the active window. Go to the relevant window, for example the project window, and use Ctrl and Alt on Mac or Ctrl Alt and Shift on Windows and Linux, and the left and right arrows to stretch the window left or right. This also works with the tool window at the bottom. Use Ctrl-Alt on Mac or Ctrl-Alt and Shift on Windows and Linux, and the up or down arrows to stretch the window up or down. As you can see, this file has long lines. Let's prevent horizontal scrolling by using Softwrap. If you want to do something but don't remember the shortcut or menu option, use Find Action. Command Shift and A on Mac or Control Shift and A on Windows and Linux. Let's search for Softwrap. We get the option to turn on Softwrap, which will be for this file only. Alternatively, we can configure Softwrap. Let's select Softwrap these files, which includes markdown files like this one. Click Apply and OK. Now we see that long lines are wrapped and there's no more horizontal scrolling. We recommend using shortcuts as much as possible. This is easier to do during a presentation than using a mouse or a trackpad, especially if you get nervous and your hands might get slippery. Let's take a look at some shortcuts for navigation. We can find a class using Command and O on Mac or Control and N on Windows and Linux. In the Spring Pet Clinic project, let's look for a vet controller. We can move the caret to a method and use Command and B on Mac or Control and B on Windows and Linux to go to the declaration or usages of that method. We can also navigate backwards by using Command and left square bracket on Mac or Control Alt left on Windows and Linux. Or navigate forward by using Command and right square bracket on Mac or Control Alt right on Windows and Linux. Use Shift Command and E on Mac or Ctrl-Shift-E on Windows and Linux to find recent locations. This is another way to go back to the method where we just were. Or find last edited locations with Shift-Command-Backspace on Mac or Ctrl-Shift-Backspace on Windows and Linux. Finally, we can find recent files using Command and E on Mac or Control and E on Windows and Linux. For more information, please check the links below. Good luck presenting with IntelliJ IDEA, and thanks for watching.